I never lied to you. I don't ever want to see you again.
Come back inside now, Beth. You need your rest.
I think it is.
I'm afraid so. My God.
It's all the makings for a bomb. Where would he get that stuff?
It's a military issue. Exactly the same kind of materials that was used to blow up Billy Lewis's car. Tony, it looks like Eli Sims is definitely our man.
Now, some other words, Commander Sims.
Oh, he just dropped me off, honey. He didn't want to come in.
Well, that's funny. I thought he'd want to be here with Annabelle involved in everything. Hi, Mom.
Hi,
glad you're here.
Yeah, me too. You know, at first I really didn't want to come, honey, but Eli convinced me how important it was to hear the whole mystery behind that picture.
But why did you bring Dad's camera?
Eli thought it might help Henry remember what happened on that fishing trip.
I wish Tony never found that thing in the first place. It's caused nothing but trouble.
Well, Father, it's nearly time. When Tony and HB arrive, we can begin. Father, did you hear me?
That camera.
What?
That camera that B's holding. I think that was Tom Raven's, the one he used to take the picture with on the fishing trip. Which is the reason we all have to be here tonight.
This portion is presented by Mr. Clean, for a clean so shiny you might think it's wet, and by pH Balanced Secret, strong enough for a man but made for a woman.
Yes, Chief, I just called Judge Shine. He's issuing a search warrant for the Reardon house, so get someone over there, pick it up, and get it over to me, would you? Yeah, I also want an APB put out on Eli Sims along with a warrant for his arrest. Yeah, that's it for now. I'll talk to you later. Tony? Put all that stuff back. None of this is legal until I get a warrant.
Ross, this is Annabelle's father. How am I going to tell her this?
If you want, I'll do it.
No, I got to do it.
All right, look, come on. It's almost 6 o'clock. We should get over to the Chamberlain house.
You go ahead over there.
Store it.
I'll meet you over there later, okay? This is my house. I want to make sure that the cops don't miss anything when they search it.
All right, Tony, remember what I said about the commander?
Don't worry. I'll let the cops handle him. Ross!
Yeah.
Get this.
I think I will take this with me.
What's it just head out of, over here.
Don't you go to the sort of,
didn't you know?
Bea, do you know where Tony is?
Annabelle! I didn't even know you two were back.
Yeah, we got back this afternoon, but he went over to Ross's office, and I haven't seen him since.
Well, did you try calling Ross's office?
Yeah, and neither of them has been there for hours.
Oh, I wish he wouldn't go running off and disappearing. I can't take it much longer, Annabelle.
I wish H.B. would get here. I'm afraid something's happened to him.
Darling, don't go getting yourself upset, please.
Yeah, she's right. H.B.'s going to show up. He'll probably show up just in time to make a grand entrance.
Billy, could I talk to you a second, please?
Sure. Will you excuse me one second?
Oh, surely, surely.
Jesus, please.
Mm-hmm. What is it?
Why isn't H.B. here yet?
You know H.B. He's always late.
Okay, we're not talking about a party here, Billy. He swore he would be here. I'm getting worried about him.
Tell you the truth, I am, too. Why don't I give Ross a call?
Hey, darling, you have a phone I can use privately?
Yes, right out in the hall.
Is something wrong?
No, I'm just going to try and track down H.B. and tell him to shake leg.
Good, good.
Welcome back, stranger.
Hello, Billy. Alan, come in. I'm so glad you could make it.
Thank you.
Just about getting ready to get started. Can you tell me what this is all about? Hope wasn't very specific on the phone.
Alan, hello. I'm glad you could make it.
Hello, Hope. I have to check on a few things. I hope you will fill Alan in for me, won't you? Thank you. Well, you're looking better than when I left.
Thank you. I feel better.
I hope this meeting is worth coming back early from Washington.
I think it is. There have been some terrible things happening to all our families, and I think that Henry will be able to clear that up.
Well, then I'd better speak to him.
Excuse Alan?
Yes, Hope?
I think we should talk soon. About the divorce.
We will. I'll have my lawyer arrange a meeting. Excuse me.
Hello, Vanessa. Henry.
Glad you could make it.
Hello. How was Washington?
Oh, went very well. I think the president was pleased.
Ah.
Henry, what's this all about?
Oh, you'll find out soon enough, Alan, along with everybody else.
Well, this certainly is something to come back to.
Well, this isn't the only thing you're coming back to, Alan. We have to discuss some business.
Yes, yes. I'm anxious to hear how you handled things while I was gone.
I think you'll be quite surprised.
Yeah. But we should know what it's all about after tonight.
Maybe we'll find out from all this who murdered my father.
And everybody else.
Oh, my God. Ed. Honey, what are you doing here?
Well, everything you told me about this meeting, I knew I had to be here.
But you're not supposed to be out of the hospital till tomorrow.
Well, I threw a little weight around. I got out a day early.
You shouldn't have done that.
Oh, there's too much happening, honey. I know how worried you are about your father and that picture. I didn't want you to go through that alone.
How did you get here?
Phoned a ride.
His mother came to the rescue.
Oh,
come on. You're back.
Hi, sweetheart. Yep.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
When did you get back?
Just a little while ago.
Oh.
So how's Aunt Maida?
Well, she's much better, dear, and she insisted that I come. As a matter of fact, she practically kicked me out.
You know what this is all about?
Well, Ed filled me in as much as he could, and I just can't believe it. All these terrible things come from that picture that was taken of a fishing trip.
Yeah, well, something must have happened on that fishing trip to put all this chaos in motion.
But for Bill and all those other men to keep a secret like that for over 20 years must have been... Well, it's unbelievable. Mm-hmm.
Trish.
Alan, I didn't know you were coming back.
Well, because of the meeting, I came back a day or two earlier than I had planned. I wish I had heard from you.
Well, I've been very busy.
I missed you, Trish.
Hello, how are you?
Hi.
Listen, I want to find Billy and see if he's gotten in touch with HB.
All right, good. Well, almost everyone is here.
Yeah, but what about Tony and H.B., Lewis?
Have you gotten in touch with Ross?
Yeah, he wasn't in the office. I left word for him to call here if he comes in.
Did you have any luck getting a hold of H.B.?
No. I don't know where the hell he is.
What are we going to do?
Well, it looks like we're just going to have to sit tight and wait.
Yeah, but we have to get started soon. We can't wait.
No, we can't. You're right, Nola. The story has to be told now.
Oh, wait, what about H.B., though? He might be in danger.
He is in danger, Josh. We all are. The longer we wait, the greater the danger becomes.
Yeah.
get over there, okay? I'll meet you over to Chamberlain's as soon as the cops are going upstairs.
Well, Tony, it's not going to take that long.
I know. Listen, would you not tell Annabelle that any of this is happening? I want to be there when she finds out, okay?
See you.
Show them around, Reardon. But you be quick about it. Because I'll be waiting.
Beth?
No, it's me, Mindy. Hi, Philip.
Who is it?
It's Mindy. What do you want me to tell you?
I can't
tell
you.
Hello?
Hello?
Philip, is that you?
No, it's Rick.
Would you put Philip back on the line, please?
This isn't a good time, Mindy, all right?
What's the matter with him? He sounds awful.
Hold on a second. Philip, she wants to know what's wrong. Should I tell her?
I don't care.
Mindy?
Yeah?
Phil and Beth broke up last night.
They broke up?
Yeah.
You're kidding. What happened? I mean, did he say why? Was it because of me? What did she say? Why won't Philip talk to me? Come on, what was it about?
Well, I'll tell you, it's about time. Rick, would you answer me?
Mindy, I can't talk to you right now, all right?
But when?
I don't know.
Tonight?
Yeah, sometime tonight.
Okay, well, I'll come over, okay?
No, I'll come by your place, all right?
You gonna be all right?
Yeah, I just want to be alone for a while.
Sure. Call me if you need me anything, all right, buddy?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm afraid we can't wait any longer. Would you please take your seats, fellows? I want to start by thanking all of you for coming here tonight. H.B. Lewis was supposed to be here. I cannot think what has happened to him.
Well, I'm sure he'll show up any minute, Henry.
Well, I certainly hope so, Billy, but I've got to start telling the story before something else happens to prevent it. By now, you probably all know what the story is about. It's about the last fishing trip that H.B. and Bill Bauer and Brandon Spaulding, Tom Reardon and I went on. Something happened on that trip which all five of us took a vow that we would never disclose to a single soul. But in view of everything that's happened recently, I've got to break my silence. Because it is too dangerous for all of us. I've got to tell you, and hope that this may ease some of the terror that we're all feeling at this point.
Terror? What are you talking about? What things happened?
Well, Daddy's heart attack, for one. Alan, Billy's car was blown up.
He killed my secretary.
And Annabelle's psychiatrist was murdered.
Maybe even Tom's disappearance.
My father's alleged suicide.
But what does all of this have to do with a fishing trip?
Alan, if you will notice, with one exception, everybody mentioned is either connected with someone in that fishing trip or was on that fishing trip. Well, it all started in the 50s when Bill Bauer began organizing an annual fishing trip for what he called his top echelon business connections. We were always the same group, more or less. We called ourselves the Hook, Line, and Drinkers Club. Bill used to hire Tom Reardon to take care of us. He took very good care of us as a guide. We went to a different lake every year. And that year we went
to Lake Elizabeth. It was a peaceful spot, quiet. We all just wanted to get away from the telephone. The only person who took any interest in fishing was Tom. We ate the fish he could, drank beer. We were relaxing in that peaceful atmosphere. Until she appeared.
The woman in the picture.
Yes, dear. The one who looks so like you. I could not believe my eyes when I first saw her. She appeared from nowhere, swimming.
And on the beach you'll see the girls in their bikinis, as cute as...
I called the rest of them down. I wanted to make sure I wasn't seeing things.
What's in the lake? No, a beautiful girl is right out there in the lake. No, come on, fellas. Come on.
That's right. Dreams of glory. All right. Come on.
Final ladies' man.
Two beers, boy, and you go crazy. Judy before eight. Always
be here. Henry, you're going off again, kid?
What do you say?
Buddy's right.
They all saw her. We called her. Tried to get her to come ashore.
Hey, honey! Come on in! Come on in, baby! Come on, she's the
winner. Forget it. She wouldn't. She just swam away across the lake. Disappeared.
But she did come back, didn't she?
Yes, she did. Well, we were both wrong. She did come ashore. Astonished I was when Tom told me.
Bill, get up. All right. Over here.
But there she was. She'd come to see us.
Come on, take a look.
What?
The girl.
Hey. Come on in, honey. Bill. Bill,
here I am. Come on.
Come on in.
Oh, there she is. Hey.
Come on in.
Come on.
It's cold out there. You're cold.
Hey,
come on in.
I can see the ghost pimples from here.
Come sure, on come in. On in. Some cup of coffee. What about a nice beer, huh?
Yeah.
We got towels in here and everything.
Come on,
honey.
Girl.
I'll get a towel.
Come on, sweetie. Come on.
You need some help?
This is
good.
Good.
He was a little tentative at first, but so lively, so full of energy.
Come on. Here's a chair for the queen. Here's a chair for the queen.
Oh, and a beer. A beer for the queen.
Let me get her a beer. You're warming up now? You're warming up a little bit?
That's good.
Want to try the sweater on?
Oh, yeah.
That's a good sweater. I got it on right, I think.
We offered her a beer, and she took it. I think all of us were a little in love with him.
Oh, you're going to make me too around. Around.
Except for Tom.
Thank
he
you.
Held back.
Oh, yee-hoo!
I wish we'd all held
back. Fine. What happened here?
She seemed to fit right into our group as though we'd known her forever.
Look at beside your face.
But she didn't belong with us. She didn't belong anywhere near us. Anywhere near that lake. She should never have come near us. She should never have come near us at all.
Chamberlains, the Bowers, Spaldings, and the Lewises. Sims is out to get all of them because of something that happened on that fishing trip. Hopefully, Henry Chamberlain's story will tell us what made Sims kill Gwen Harding. and what made him try to kill Henry Chamberlain and Billy Lewis. I'll find out tonight. And when I do, I'll put Eli Sims away for life. For Betty Smiley, Gwen Harding, and Bill Bauer. I know he's a murderer. But why? Why?
Of Guiding Light is presented by Jif. Choosy mothers choose Jif. And by Head & Shoulders, available in regular and conditioning formulas.
If I don't catch up with Sims in the next couple of hours, I'm going to have to put the families under surveillance. They'll need the protection. I've got the meeting. All the families are at that meeting. My God, what if Sims shows up there? He'll have them right where he wants them. What if he's there already?
What the hell was that squad car anyway?
Good
time for a blowout, huh?
Yeah, it's just as an anti-blowout. Somebody planned for it to happen.
Oh, don't worry, Mr. Marlowe. We'll have it fixed for you right away.
No, there's no time for that. You gotta take me over to the Chamberlain house right now. Let's go.
Father? Father, are you all right?
Daddy, are you sure that you can go on?
Yes, darling, yes. I have to.
Henry, what was the girl's name, the girl that came from the lake?
Annie.
Mr. Chamberlain, tell them what you told me, that she wasn't anything like me.
Annie looked like Annabelle, but there, the similarity ended. Annabelle isn't like Annie. I can understand why I thought she was when I first saw her. Annie was restless, ready for anything. She was desperate to let herself go and have a good time. And we were all too willing to show her a good time. All of us were. Bill. H.P. Brandon. I. Everybody but Tom. Tom just watched us as we kidded with her, handed her beers, told her jokes. Annie was with us for 3 days. 3 glorious golden days. Maybe it wasn't all as innocent as we thought it was then, but we never tried to compromise her. She never stayed the night. She'd arrive early in the morning and leave before dusk. Except for that last day. Then she left early. And then it happened. It was so unexpected. So horrible.
What happened?
Ross Marler, district attorney.
Mr. Marler, come on in.
Where's the meeting being held?
Right in there.
Is there a Commander Eli Sims here?
There's a lot of men in there, but I only know my employees, the Chamberlains.
Yeah, all right, Johnson, go out to the car and radio for some backup. Tell them to get here in a hurry, but no sirens, no lights. I don't want to alarm anyone. Go.
All right, I'll take care of it. What's going on?
Nothing yet. And you, don't you let anyone in this house unless I say so. Do you read me?
Loud and clear.
All right, I'm going to go in. And if Sims is in there, I'll signal you when to come in and get him.
I still don't understand why you're dredging up this old story.
Oh, Ross. Oh, I'm glad you could get here. Please come in, sit down.
Ross, where's Tony?
I just now left him. He's at the boarding house. He'll be here very soon.
Oh, thank God he's safe.
Have you any word from my father?
Why, he's not here?
No, he hasn't shown up. He hasn't called nothing, Ross.
Well, then I take it you haven't started the meeting yet?
I decided to start without HB, so if you'll all sit down, I'll go on with the story.
The dark story can wait a second, Henry. Look, I'd like you to put him in on HB's trail.
Yeah, I will, Billy. I'll call and I'll somebody to be on it right away.
Great, there's a phone right out there for you I used a little bit ago.
All right, thank you. Annabelle, have you been in touch at all with your father today?
No, why?
Well, there's something I want to talk to him about.
Ross, I saw him. He drove me over here.
When was that?
An hour ago?
Did he give you any indication as to where he might be going after he dropped you off?
No, he just said he had some errands to do, but I know he was planning to go back to the boarding house because he said he'd wait there till I called him to pick me up.
All right. Well, maybe he's back there by now.
Ross, is my father in some kind of danger?
Annabelle, I just have to ask him a couple of questions, that's all. Henry, would you mind holding off on the story for a few minutes till I make a phone call?
All right, Ross, but hurry up. It may be too late.
Home, and Bradley told me that Philip had stopped by and that you talked to him. Beth, are you all right?
I sent him away. I told him that I never wanted to see him again. Not ever.
Honey, why did you and Philip break up? Did something happen the night you were at the stable? You know, the last night you were with him, did he try to force himself on you?
What?
Did he try to take advantage of you?
Oh.
Why are you laughing?
Get out! Get out! Leave me alone!
Ross, yes, Tony, what's going on? Tony, is Sims anywhere around?
No, he's not over there either.
All right. Your mother said he was going to run a few errands, then he's going back to the boarding house.
Okay, I'll keep an eye out for him here.
Okay, make sure that the police I sent over don't leave.
Yeah, they just did.
Oh, for God's sake, do you think they'd have enough sense to stay put? Sims could be back there any minute.
Well, listen, I'll go see if I can catch him.
All right, but Tony, if you don't, call me right back, but not from the house. Stay away from the house, Tony. He's already killed two people.
Don't worry, Ross. I'm out of here.
You're not going anywhere, Reardon. B, that's Tom's camera, isn't it?
Yes, Henry, this is the camera that took that picture.
May I see it, please?
Well, of course.
Any word from HB?
No, not yet, Billy, but there's a search out on him.
Billy, why don't you call Mindy? Maybe he's with her.
No, I left specific instructions with Fred to call here if HB showed up.
Josh, I've got the most terrible feeling. Ross, shouldn't Tony be here by now?
Annabelle, I just talked with him on the phone. He's going to be right over.
Were you able to reach Eli?
No, not yet, but I will be very soon.
If everyone's ready, I'd like to go on with the story, please.
Yes, Henry, by all means.
Ross,
I've just been telling them about the fishing trips we used to go on. On that last one, we met this extraordinary girl. The girl in the picture. Her name was Annie. This camera. I remember Tom sneaking around, taking pictures of us when we least expected it. That last day, Annie came back all dressed up. She had on a beautiful white dress. One of the fellows said she looked like Cinderella.
Hello, Beauty. I didn't recognize you with your clothes on. Come in here.
And we decided she better have a dance. So we gave one right there on the campsite. Tom's radio provided the music. And Annie had four overage and grade Prince Charming to dance with. It was while we were dancing that it occurred to me we ought to have a group picture, something to remember Annie by. Tom always had trouble getting a group picture of us, especially when Annie was around, because we kept horsing around like a bunch of high school kids.
All right, get around in with the beers. Hold them up, everyone, toasting to the lady. Okay?
This time, I remember he said, it's a good one. He would send us all copies. He never did. So shortly after that, Tom disappeared. It was while we were dancing around that Annie suddenly decided she wanted to go out on the lake. Well, none of us could refuse her anything, and although we all had a drop taken, we were feeling a little crazy, and we all went with her. That is, everybody except Tom.
You one pretty girl. Why don't you do a little bit of skinny dipping for us?
I can't recall too much of what happened that day. I was a little annoyed at what was going on. I'd been drinking too much. More than was good for me. And I was feeling my liquor. But I do have a vague recollection that HB dared her to take off her dress and jump in the lake. Started trying to get her to go back into the boat. Then they got mad because they thought she was teasing them. I think I must have dozed off, but I could vaguely hear HB and Brandon, Bill, trying to get her to go back in the boat. But she never got back in. She just kept
kept on swimming, swimming away from all of us.
What happened to her, Henry?
I didn't know at the time because I passed out. But when we got back to shore, I asked H.B., and he said, she'd gone. She just swam away and disappeared. Our Annie was gone.
Henry, what do you mean this girl just disappeared?
Well, I couldn't believe it myself. But H.B. and Brandon and your father said that was exactly what had happened.
Well, didn't they try to look for it at all?
I asked them that. H.B. said they'd waited around for almost half an hour.
Nobody's going to do anything about that. She's leaving home.
She never showed up.
Come on back.
They kept calling, calling her name. She never answered. Finally, H.B. got tired of it. And H.B. threw her dress into the water. Back to camp.
What happened to the girl? Did you ever find out?
We left her there. In the middle of the lake. Just left her there. We were to blame for what happened to her. It was all our fault.
I forgot to ask. What are you doing here?
I'm just a boarder. I live down the hall. I heard the commotion. I thought I'd drop by, see if there's anything I could do. Isn't that right, Tony? Yeah.
Well, thanks, but we've taken care of everything. I just wanted to know if Mr. Marler wanted us to call him.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, he did. He's over at the Chamberlain house. He wants you to call him right away.
If I were you two, I wouldn't stick around here, just in case the guy who lives here comes back.
Sure, sure, officer. We'll be careful. Right, Tony?
Yeah. Thanks.
That wasn't very smart, Tony.
What?
Trying to tip that policeman off to call the district attorney?
Hey, if I didn't tell him to call the DA would have been suspicious. I'm supposed to call him myself, as a matter of fact.
Are you? Call him! Now. Now, maybe we can have some time to ourselves.
So now what, are you going to kill me?
She? Damn it! Where's my daughter?
She's where she's safe.
Safe from what?
Safe from you!
No. You got it all wrong, Tony. I'm gonna save her from you. From all of you. And I'm gonna do it soon.
Very, very soon.